It turns out that scientists can actually make the Vulcan mind melt happen. Mm. These are researchers at the University of Washington, and they used brain electricity in order to help manipulate the brain of someone else. So basically, there were these two researchers. They're wearing all this headgear so they can control one another. And one researcher thinks about firing a cannon in a video game. And just by thinking it, he can manipulate the action of the other researcher who is literally on the other side of campus. We have a video showing this to you, so let's take a quick look.
All right, there's the game.
Watch. So there's the one researcher, he's just thinking about it.
Yes! Success.
All right.
And then look at this one. Boom.
Yes! All right.
So it was like a little twitch, right? But it was involuntary. He did not do that on his own. It was because the original researcher, the first one, just thought, all right, I'm ready to fire the cannon. And then boom, I'm going to fire the cannon with my mind. And then this guy is actually going to fire the cannon with his finger.
Now, that's one of the most amazing technologies I've ever heard of. But if I have to wear that purple hat to do it, I'm not sure I'm in. Okay.
Yeah.
It's at the first stages, obviously, right? Mm-hmm. And they strap you in with the whole thing. And in the past, what I got on the article from Reuters was that if the other guy did the action, it could trigger the action on the other, you know, from the other person from a different place. Now he just has to think about the action.
It's insane.
So in yesterday's post game, we had a wild, wild discussion about cars that can drive themselves. It's just right around the corner. It's in about 7 years. We think Nissan's going to be able to do it. Obviously, there's the Google car too. Now, if you were worried about, and we were talking about this in the post game, the government tapping the cars that can drive themselves, well, what if they can control our mind and they tap into that? And they tap into our, you know, our mainframe in our, now look, right now you'd have to volunteer for it. It's an incredibly early stage, you'd have to strap yourself in. But what if they can get better than just like a little tick reaction and they made it involuntary.
Can I do a little bit of fear-mongering on the show?
Yes, I thought I was just in the middle of it right now.
Just a little bit. Okay, just to give you guys a little more context into the study, it was funded by the U.S. Army Research Office.
Oh.
Why do they want to study this?
Okay, but it's the same office that funded research on the internet. So they do a lot.
And they're using the internet to spy on all of us.
Think about it. And it's the same group that guy came up with the microwave.
And they're using that to
Hot Pockets.
Totally.
Think about it.
But what's incredible is that, you know, our brain has these electrical signals, and that you can use them to manipulate someone else.
No, it's amazing.
I know, right?
Look, I mean, the substance of the story is ridiculous. I was positive that only Spock could do this. And now it turns out we can all do it. Yeah. But think about it, man. You can just think something, and someone somewhere else has strapped into you actually does the thing involuntarily. It's amazing. I can't get beyond how amazing
it is. It's amazing. You know what? But who wants to be on the other side? What benefit do I have to be the pawn? You know?
Oh, yeah, there are benefits.
Do you want to explain?
Yeah, so one possible benefit, for example, is the airplane's pilot has a heart attack, and nobody can land the plane. Okay, you strap in, there's a pilot on the ground, goes, bleep, 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 bleep. I am thinking of you landing the plane. And you're like, oh, sick dude, I am landing it. Okay, so, but JR, ultimately you're right. It always starts with like, oh, we're treating Alzheimer's, we're doing this, we're doing that. Like tiny little benefits that seem like kind of fun. And then next thing you know, the government is taking over all our brains.
Right,
a lot. Yeah, I mean, the possible downside of this is fairly high.